Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone. In my series of lectures, today's number is 50th, and today I am going to discuss how safely we can take calcium to prevent osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is a type of bone disease where if enough calcium is not there, our bone density will be reduced and it will be brittle, it will not be elastic, and we will get lot of joint pain. That is due to the deficiency of calcium in your body. So in that circumstances, to prevent osteoporosis, we, most of us, go for calcium supplement. And when we are taking calcium supplement, we have to be very careful. It's not that any doctor is saying go and take 1000 mg or 500 mg of calcium and it will be okay. No, calcium is very sensitive in the sense that if it is taken in extra quantity, you know, this calcium will take up your vitamin D and you will become deficient in your vitamin D. Your vitamin D deficiency causes your immune system to become very, very poor, or you can say that you will be subjected to different type of infection, even to cancer or diseases, because your immune system will become poor in absence of your vitamin D. That's why it is better to get proper, diagnosis by a doctor to get the exact amount in a safe way, your calcium. And everybody needs 400 international unit IU of vitamin D. Whether you are taking supplement of calcium or not, your daily intake of vitamin D should be 400 IU. And for that, if you just expose your hand or leg skin just for 15 to 20 minutes in the sun, you will get enough vitamin D. That's why I call vitamin D as sunshine vitamin. And I have noticed this thing when I visited Delhi just last month. Not only in Delhi, in whole India, the infants, children, they are deficient in vitamin D. And that's why doctors, they advise to give them the vitamin D drop. And the reason is that most of them, they are not exposed to sunlight. They are in tight compartment, inflated system, and where enough sunlight is not coming, and the children are not exposed to sunlight. So it is very important for all of us to, at least every day, expose our body to sunlight. And here I have given you, many people take calcium as a supplement to help prevent osteoporosis. They may increase the risk of certain infection, inflammation, and even cancer if they are taking in large quantity, in excess quantity. That's why along with calcium, there must be some amount of vitamin D also. Otherwise, definitely you will lose your immune system. Your immune system will become poor and lot of different type of infections will be there. And my advice is better at least to check your vitamin D in your body. What is the level of your vitamin D? If there is deficiency of vitamin D, it's a very serious issue. Most of the people in India, they don't go for vitamin D checkup, because vitamin D deficiency means, it brings lot of complications. You will be subjected to lot of variety of infections. Your immune system will be poor. They cannot fight the incoming germs because of deficiency of vitamin D. So vitamin D is very, very important. And once you take calcium in excess, your vitamin D level will go down. So, and even cancer, taking extra calcium, use up vitamin D, and lack of vitamin D impairs immune system, which can cause infections and even cancer. To prevent deficiency, you need at least 400 IU of vitamin D per day, whether you take calcium supplement or not. You can get vitamin D by exposing few inches of your skin to sunlight each day. Rich source of vitamin D include your fatty fish, egg, liver and butter. Your milk is not very good source of vitamin D because it contains calcium, you know, and that inhibit this your vitamin D. So the best source is your egg, fatty fish, your liver and butter. Yeah, in continuation, all people, they need 1000 milligram of calcium per day. And this calcium, 1000 milligram, we can get from 4 glasses of milk or 4 glasses of yogurt. And sometimes in India, due to poverty, it is difficult for masses to afford every day 4 glasses of milk. So in that case, they can go for that residue of yogurt. Yogurt means dahi. So what they do, they just remove the creamy layer and the residue is remaining, that filtered, and that residue is called mattha or chhach. So that is still intact, rich in calcium, and that is sold at throwaway price. They can go and they can take. Nowadays they are doing the marketing of chhach and mattha, and they can use that in place of milk if they cannot afford, and that will meet their requirements of 1000 milligram of calcium. And here you should not go for expensive chelated calcium. Nowadays lot of commercial chelated calciums, coated calcium combined with magnesium calcium, highly crystalline, microfine crystal, all are just having the same value. If you take calcium carbonate, that is 600 milligram tablet in the form of pills, those in India, they eat, you know, pan, dali, and then they call it chuna. That is your calcium carbonate and calcium hydroxide. If you take that calcium carbonate, the cheapest source of calcium. This is your calcium carbonate. And the other supplements what they are selling, they call that chelated calcium with magnesium. And they say that with this chelated magnesium, the absorption of calcium will be very fast. Don't believe. Is wrong. Once calcium comes in its ionic form, Ca positive, once it is in ionic form, Ca double positive, this calcium will freely go for absorption. Magnesium ion is not going to increase its absorption. So the best way is that go for cheapest tablet, that is calcium carbonate. It is available in the market. You buy in that 600 mg or 400 mg, whatever, the doses they have, and better you take that, because now in India I have noticed that a lot of calcium in a very complex form and very costly, where common people cannot afford. So don't go for all those things, just go for simple calcium carbonate tablet. And also, the one source of calcium is when we are taking antacid. So be particular, means if you are suffering from hyperacidity, of course your stomach is not going to be affected from that antacid, but your intestine will be neutralized if you take antacid. So in that case, there are three types of antacid. Either it is with calcium carbonate or aluminium or magnesium. So avoid any antacid with aluminium or magnesium. Just go with those antacid. If you check it, whether calcium carbonate is there or not, or calcium ion is not there. Once calcium ion is there in your antacid, that is the excellent source of dietary calcium for you. So here, all people need 100 milligram calcium each day. This amount of calcium is found in your 4 glasses of milk. If you take calcium supplements, take the recommended daily requirement of vitamin D of 400 IU per day. Don't waste your money on expensive chelated calcium pills or supplements that combine magnesium with calcium. And antacid like calcium carbonate is an excellent source of your dietary calcium, that is your calcium carbonate. So please, be safe, be on safe side when you are taking your calcium to prevent osteoporosis, because excess calcium, you should always check with qualified, experienced consultant. Don't go to those physicians, they are just treating with window medicine and they don't have enough deep knowledge of physiology or medicinal chemistry to understand deep inside chemistry. They can recommend anything, go and take 500 milligram in the morning, 500 milligram in the evening, so you have excess of calcium, because already from your dietary source, you are every day you are getting 400 to 600 milligram of calcium from your diet. So rest you can go for 400 to 500 milligram to maintain your calcium in your body to prevent osteoporosis. So taking calcium as a safer side is very important. Otherwise, you will lose your vitamin D, and which will complicate your health, and you will be facing lot of problem. And it's my advice, if you get time, better check your vitamin C level in your body. If there is deficiency, please take vitamin D to maintain it. Thank you very much.